That brings us to the question, why does the world turn a blind eye to Saudi Arabia? Because Saudi Arabia's link to terrorism is nothing new. The Sri Lankan Prime Minister spoke about a possible link with the Lankan blasts, the Lankan attacks, and Saudi Arabia. And yet, no one seems to question the royal family in Riyadh or Saudi Arabia. There's been one clear-cut reason for this silence, and that is oil. Saudi Arabia is the largest exporter of petroleum in the world. It possesses around 18% of the world's proven petroleum reserves, and that's just petroleum. In terms of total oil production, Saudi Arabia is the third largest in the world after the US and Russia. Among the members of OPEC, Saudi Arabia produces more oil than the next two members put together, that's Iran and Iraq. And you know what states they're in right now. Now, the U.S. has tightened the pressure on Iran. Tensions between the U.S. and Iran are on the rise. There are sanctions against countries which buy oil from Iran. The Trump administration is also opposed to the government in Venezuela. The Latin American country's oil production is slipping due to crippling sanctions. And with this growing pressure on Iran and Venezuela, who gains? Saudi Arabia. The influence of Saudi Arabia in oil markets is only set to grow in the days ahead. Riyadh also has a strong friend in Donald Trump, the U.S. president. He even wanted to move forward with a $2 billion arms deal with Saudi Arabia last month. He vetoed the Congress on U.S. policy on Yemen, a country that Saudi Arabia has been attacking. Trump enjoys healthy ties with Saudi Arabia and the royal family. This friendship translates to business deals as well, both for the government of the U.S. and for Donald Trump. Saudi Arabian government also enjoys cordial relationship with Russian President Vladimir Putin, as well as Chinese President Xi Jinping, all powerful figures. Riyadh is busy funding terror while the world looks the other way. Saudi Arabia remains the biggest sponsor of Islamic terrorism in the world, be it Iran, Iraq, Syria, Yemen, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Egypt, Libya, even the United States. The source of terror and funding invariably leads to the kingdom of Riyadh. The Salafist ideology that is promoted by Saudi Arabia is wreaking havoc in this region and across the world. This ideology is the driving force for terror outfits like the Al-Qaeda. A report published by the Financial Action Task Force, the global watchdog on terror funding last year, says that Saudi Arabia is not effectively investigating and prosecuting individuals involved in large-scale or professional activity and, quote-unquote, not effectively confiscating the proceeds of this crime. In light of this report, one would expect strict action against Saudi Arabia by the world, but the reality is quite the opposite. Saudi Arabia, may we tell you, was elected as the chair of the United Nations Human Rights Commission Advisory Committee a few years back, and this is nothing short of scandalous. Saudi Arabia beheads more people than the ISIS does. It has executed people who wanted free elections in the country, but the world cannot do anything against the regime in Riyadh because they want oil. The U.S. should be worried about the close ties it shares with Saudi Arabia, but America lauded the country when Saudi Arabia decided to go for an image makeover. In an effort to win over critics, Saudi Arabia allowed women to ride vehicles last year. In this day and age, finally women being allowed to drive. The Western press made a big deal out of it. A few months later, the murder of Jamal Khashoggi took the world by storm. The U.S., we say, must be cautious. According to a 2009 diplomatic cable to U.S. State Department, the then Secretary of State Hillary Clinton urged caution. She wanted America to block money from Gulf from going to terrorists in Pakistan and Afghanistan. This is worrying for India as well. She identified that donors in Saudi Arabia are the biggest contributors to terror funding. Listen to this. 15 of the 19 hijackers who were responsible for the 9/11 terror attacks originated from Saudi Arabia. And that's not all. Osama bin Laden was educated in Saudi Arabia. He was a Saudi Arabian citizen. America has a stated position on terror, the so-called war on terror, yet it caught Saudi Arabia. Successive governments have done it. The violence in Afghanistan and Pakistan is bankrolled by donors from the Gulf Arab states, Saudi Arabia and Qatar. Studies show that most of the suicide bombers in Iraq are Saudi Arabians. Even Lashkar-e-Toiba, which carried out the 2008 Mumbai attacks, used a Saudi-based front company to fund its activities. The threat is clear, but no country wants to be in the bad books of Riyadh. The U.S. wants to sell arms to Saudi Arabia. It needs Riyadh to have an influence in the region. Russia also courts this regime. The might of the oil wealth makes the world overlook the bloodshed provoked and funded by the Saudi regime.